Hello everyone, I, Jhalak Patel, Assistant Professor at LG Institute of Engineering and Technology in the Department of Electronics and Communication, welcomes you to the session of Power Electronics. Today, I am going to discuss about Unit 2, that is Control Rectifiers, with topic Semiconverter Different Parameters and Examples. So, let's start the session. First of all, as we discussed in the last lecture about the analysis of semiconverter, that it has the different values like the DC voltage, RMS load voltage, then we also discuss about different parameters like FSF, then we discuss about the CDF and discuss about the PF, means power factor. So in the last lecture we have derived the equation of power factor, that is given by 2 root 2 cos square alpha by 2 upon pi minus alpha raised to 1 by 2. Here alpha is firing angle. If we rearrange this term, then it could be like this. Here cos square alpha by 2, cos square alpha is equal to 1 plus cos 2 alpha by 2. So here cos square alpha by 2, so it can be written as 1 plus cos alpha divided by 2. This 2 and 2 will be cancelled out. So the power factor can be written as root 2 into 1 plus cos alpha upon pi into pi minus alpha raised to 1 by 2. So now HF means input harmonic factor. Input harmonic factor is given by the value of harmonics divided by its fundamental value, and it can be given as Is RMS square minus I1 RMS square upon I1 RMS raised to 1 by 2. Here this Is RMS is called as a fundamental value of current, and this is the current of supply voltage. So it can be written like this. Now this equation comes here using dividing this equation of numerator with I1 RMS. If you see this equation, then Is RMS upon I1 RMS, this equation will becomes Is RMS upon I1 RMS, and Is RMS upon I1 RMS is nothing but CDF. So we already have the value of the CDF in the last lecture, so simply we have to put it over here. So it is pi minus pi alpha upon 8 cos square alpha by 2. And this I1 RMS and I1 RMS will be cancelled out, so this term will become 1. So harmonic factor is given like this, pi into pi minus alpha upon 8 cos square alpha by 2 minus 1 raised to 1 by 2. Now here 2 cos square alpha, in the last equation if you see the term in the denominator, here cos square alpha by 2 is present in the equation, so this cos square alpha by 2 will become 1 plus cos alpha by 2. So we can write down it like this, 2 cos square alpha by 2 is equal to 1 plus cos alpha. So the last equation of previous slide, now it can be written like this, HF is equal to pi into pi minus alpha upon 4 into 1 plus cos alpha minus 1 raised to 1 by 2. This is the harmonic factor of the semiconverter. Now active power. So active power is one useful term, it is one type of useful power, and according to the basic electronics, the active power definition can be written like this, active power denoted by P subscript A is equal to Vs RMS into Is1 RMS into cos phi. Now over here this is supply RMS voltage, this is fundamental value of current, and this is the power factor cos phi 1. So this equation can be written like this, here Vs RMS as it is. We already studied about the fundamental value of current in the last lecture. So it can be written like this, Is1 RMS is equal to 2 root 2 I0 upon pi into cos alpha by 2. This is the value of Is1 RMS and cos phi. It is written as the factor, power factor. So over here we write cos alpha by 2. Now we will simplify this last equation of active power. So this equation can be written like this: Vs RMS into 2 root 2 I 0 upon pi as it is. Here cos alpha by 2 into cos alpha by 2. So it becomes cos square alpha by 2. So now the active power can be written like this: Vs RMS into 2 root 2 I 0 upon pi into cos square alpha by 2. This is called as a active power. It can also be written like this. Here if you note this, this is the RMS value. You can also write it in the terms of maximum voltage term, because maximum voltage Vm upon root 2 is equal to VRMS, so it can also written in terms of VRMS. We can also write down this equation into this term, like 2 cos square alpha by 2. Here in the multiplication, if you see here the multiplication, 2 will be taken. So 2 into cos square alpha by 2, it becomes 1 plus cos alpha. So active power will be like this: Vm upon Vm into I0 upon pi as it is. This 2 into cos square alpha by 2 will becomes 1 plus cos alpha. So whole equation will be written like this. This is the equation of active power. This all equation can be asked for the numericals. So now as I discussed that this is the active power, means useful power, and therefore its value should be as high as possible. Ideally it is 1, means 100% active power is preferable, but practically it is not possible to get the 100% power. Next is reactive power. Reactive power is is generally not a preferable term, and it is generally given by, according to the basic electronics definition, it is given by PR, denoted by capital P, and subscript R, means reactive power. It is equal to Vs RMS into Is1 RMS into sin phi. Here please note that here the multiplication sin phi will be taken in case of reactive power, while in case of active power with multiplication cos phi will be taken. So now if we put all the values here, Vs RMS means supply voltage RMS value, this is the fundamental value of supply current, and this is the power factor. So if we put the values, then it will be like this. Again we put Is1 RMS value, that is 2 root 2 I0 upon pi cos alpha by 2. This is the value of fundamental component of supply current, into sin alpha by 2. This phi can be written in the terms of firing angle or in a term of delay angle. So it can be like sin phi 1 is equal to sin alpha by 2. This is Vs RMS as it is. So the reactive power can be written like this. If we rearrange in this term, then it will become root 2 into Vs RMS. This root 2, root 2 into Vs RMS, I0 as it is, upon pi as it is. So the remaining term is 2 into cos alpha by 2 into sin alpha by 2. Now if you see this term, only these terms, this is 2, this cos alpha by 2 and sin alpha by 2. So this 2 sin alpha by 2 into cos alpha by 2 will become the sin 2 alpha. It is the equation like 2 sin theta into cos theta. So it becomes sin 2 theta. So we can also write this equation like sin alpha. So it can be written like this: root 2 into Vs RMS into I0 upon pi sin alpha. And here again this is RMS value into root 2. So RMS value is basically, RMS value is given by the maximum value of Vm upon root 2. So we can also write down this like Vm into I0 upon pi into sin alpha. So this is our value for reactive power. So reactive power is a useless part of total input power, because total input power has the active power plus reactive power, in which the reactive power is not the desirable term, so it should be as minimum as possible, while active power should be as high as possible. So its value is almost equal to zero, but practically it is not possible to take it as a zero, and it is only travels between the source to load. Now let's take one example related to it. The semiconductor in the figure is connected to 120 volt 60 hertz supply. The load current can be assumed to be continuous and ripple free. Here the delay angle is 90 degree. Then calculate DC voltage, normalized voltage, RMS voltage, harmonic function, distortion factor and power factor. So first of all, this is the figure. Here you can see that two SCRs and two diodes are connected. This construction is of a symmetric construction for semiconductor. So here first let's note down the values that are given in the problem statement, that is RMS voltage is 120 volt and the delay is firing angle is 90 degree. So let's first calculate the VLDC. So average output voltage is given by VLDC is equal to Vm upon pi into 1 plus cos alpha. We already have the value of this Vm and alpha. So let's put it over here. Vm means maximum value. We have the value of RMS voltage in the problem statement. So Vm can be written as root 2 times RMS value. So root 2 times RMS value means 120 upon pi into 1 plus cos pi by 2. So it becomes like 54 volt for average output voltage. Now let's calculate the another term, that is normalized average output voltage. If you remember the analysis of semiconductor, Vn can be given like this, 0.5 into 1 plus cos alpha. Simply put the value of alpha over here, so it becomes 0.5 into 1 plus cos 90. Cos 90 is 0, that means normalized average output is 0.5 volt. So this is the answer of our second term. Now let's see the next. It is RMS load voltage. RMS load voltage for semiconductor is given by this equation. So for example, you have to remember the final equation of each term because you have to put the values over here. So if you put the values over here, it is 120 RMS value, this is Vm upon root 2. So we simply put it over here, only RMS value that is given in the problem statement is 120 1 upon pi into pi minus pi by 2, that is firing angle, plus sine 2 times alpha, 2 times pi by 2. So it becomes sine pi upon 2 into 1 by 2. So this is 84.85 volt. Next is about the harmonic factor. It is given like this, CDF 1 upon CDF square minus 1 raised to 1 by 2. So first we have to find out the individual term of IS RMS, means fundamental component as well as the supply current component. So it is given by IS RMS is given by 0.707 I0, and the second one is given by 2 root 2 I0 upon pi cos alpha by 2. This is the fundamental value of supply current. So if you find out, it can be like this, pi by 2 is firing angle, so it becomes cos pi by 4. If you solve this, it is like this, 0.6366 I0. So now the fundamental component is also in the multiple of I0 and the original supply current is also in the multiple of I0, so it can be cancelled out if we take the ratio. So it is like this. If we put the values, this is the harmonic factor. So it becomes 0.483, that is 48.3%. Next is about displacement factor. So displacement factor is simply given by cos alpha by 2. We have the value of alpha, 1 pi by 2. So pi by 2 divided by 2 means cos pi by 4. It is 1 upon root 2. Means 0.707, means 70.7% displacement factor. Next is about the power factor. It is given by fundamental current upon supply current into cos alpha by 2. We already have both the values in the previous slides. in the multiple of I0, so I0 and I0 will be cancel out, so it becomes like this. These values, it is multiple of I0, this is multiple of I0, so I0 and I0 cancel out, it becomes like this. So final answer will be 0.6366. So this is the example of semiconductor with using different parameters. We also see one another example about it in the next session, and then we move towards the full converter with the center trap converter. Okay, so if you have any doubt up to this, you can ask me on my WhatsApp number. Thank you for watching.